Hello Aries and welcome to the Green Woman Tarot. This is your reading for the next 2 weeks, which is from the 15th to the 29th of November 2021. And it's a general reading just to see what sort of energies are around you at this time, to see what's on the cards for you. But before we delve into the tarot reading, I need to consult the oracle. And this is a compendium of witches' oracle that I'll be using today to draw a couple of cards from, just to start your reading off with. So let's see what words of wisdom does the mysterious oracle have for Aries for the 15th to the 29th of November 2021. What messages are here for Aries for the next 2 weeks? What does Aries need to know at this time? Oh, okay. I'll just take that one and I'll fan these and choose another one from it. And let's see what you get. Right, you've got familiar, which is about a good bond, a bond that brings guidance, wisdom, and protectiveness. You know, someone looking out for you. So you've got the familiar and a mountain. Right, so the mountain is about a challenge you need to face, a difficulty, a big task you'd be taking on. And with the familiar, you have some guidance, you have some help along the way, company perhaps as well. So that's lovely, really. With the mountain, the familiar makes it all a lot easier and a lot more manageable. But it's sort of, with the mountain, it sort of shows a feat that you must endure, and the familiar shows good companionship and helpfulness as well, not just simply the compatibility aspect, but also the guidance, the help, the wise words it may help, you know, that guidance may bring you. But let's see where the rest of the reading goes. So let's see what's on the cards for Aries for the 15th to the 29th of November 2021. What messages are here for Aries for the next 2 weeks? What does Aries need to know at this time? So this is the Robin Woods tarot that I'll be using today, and I'll be putting down an 8-card spread for you, Aries, with the first 2 cards depicting you in your current situation, where you are now. The next 2 cards highlighting the challenges you may be facing at this time. And the following 2 cards offering you some guidance from divine energies as you move towards the final 2 cards, which may reveal your possible outcome to this time period. It'll show the energies you're moving towards. So let's see. We'll start here with the 6 of Swords and the 2 of Cups. That's just what this says as well. You have the 4 of Wands and the 10 of Pentacles in your challenge positions. You have the Ace of Pentacles and the King of Wands in your guidance row. And then you move towards the 4 of Pentacles and the 4 of Cups. So you're moving towards stability. And there you have at the bottom of the deck the 10 of Cups, joy. This is the happy home card, the ideal family sort of situation, where although it's not about affluence, it's about having the love and support that's reciprocated within your group, within your family. and the ability to appreciate that. So that's a lovely card at the bottom of the deck, which I think I'll put there for you. So where you are now, you're moving through a difficult period, or you're coming out of a difficult period, moving through, transitioning through choppy waters, through troubled times, towards calmer, more peaceful times with a goal in sight. And as you can see here, this transition is aided. And there you have the familiar. And also with the familiar, this good bond, there's this potential here. You've found someone, you've found a connection, whether it's with, you know, as a general reading, we can say whether it's work or within a friendship group, or reconnecting even with someone in your family. But for many of you, you may see this as a romantic connection. And it's linked with moving towards a better place. So perhaps in finding this bond, you're hoping that this connection, this new bond, is going to bring you to something better, maybe reveal a better side of you. And your challenge now is more of what you're wanting. It's more of what your aspirations are. The Four of Wands right above the Two of Cups, this is often a card of... What's that? Sorry, there was something showing on my screen. This is a card of engagement, or celebrating... something, having something to celebrate within a family or within a community, and it often depicts an engagement. So it's almost like, to me, seeing these two cards moving on to those two cards is almost like your aspirations, which is your challenge, which is a big quest, it's a big ask, to take this moment of connection, this joyful connection which you've put a lot of hope into, to take that and move it forward to celebrating that union with others, and making it permanent, making it something stable and secure. This is the Ten of Pentacles, having everything you want. It's the family. Again, it's another happy family card, and you've got two of them in this spread, which is sort of very telling. So it's about moving forward. Your challenge is perhaps, I get a sense of not moving this too quickly. You want now, you've found this connection, and you want to make it permanent, you want to make it stable, for many of you, it may be like you found someone you want to marry them. But if that sort of, we don't move that quickly. If you want to be logical and wise about life, you know, you can't just rush things forward. So you're hoping, you're wanting this to become something permanent. You're wanting it to become the one, and that's the challenge is to slow that desire down and sort of work with it more carefully, so that it can become something permanent. And your guidance, you know, it's all very positive actually. Your guidance rose says that, you know, this is a potential here of something that can bring you the stability, the security, this sense of growth and abundance, but it's got to be worked at. You've got to take time, and you may need to move through an uncomfortable period. You've got to accept a challenge in this. So although it is positive, there's a sense of having to work hard at it, having to focus at it, having to put a lot of effort and energy into it. And you ask here, not, you know, like the King of Wands, this is someone with a lot of willpower, a lot of desire, a lot of passion, but he's mastered all that. He's toned it down. Unlike the young Knight of Wands, who just rushes in without any planning or forethought, hastily moving to what he wants, the King of Wands has mastered that burning passion, and he's able to sort of get what he wants in a slower, more mature way. So there's your guidance. Work at it, because it is a wonderful potential that can bring you joy and happiness, and but above all of that, stability and security and value. Take your time is what the guidance is. Take your time and let that passion burn steadily, slowly, into something strong, into something stable. And if you're able to do that, you're moving towards holding on to what is of value to you. And almost to the point where you reach, sort of, you become a bit complacent about it. I get a sense here, what it's, the whole spread together says, this is wonderful now where this connection is, it's passionate, you put a lot of effort and you know you want a lot from it, you put a lot of hope into it, but once that initial spark, that initial excitement wears off, you're left with a situation that, or in a position where you sort of may want to turn, you may find yourself wondering whether you've hemmed yourself in, whether you've missed other opportunities, whether you're feeling discontent. However, if you take things slowly and build a stable connection, so take that spark, that inspiring beginning, and build stably, build slowly, and don't expect it to just remain in this state of excitement. You'll be feeling secure. You'll have all the positive aspects of the fours, the groundedness, the security, the stability, without feeling that you've cut yourself out from other potentials and fun. Because, you know, you have here at the bottom of the deck, this is something that is wholesome. This connection is something that could be one true, happy, reciprocative, loving situation. It's just not expecting it to always be in a state of newness and in a state of excitement. So in a way, it's a lovely connection, but it's something that you could learn from, something that may well teach you that even these deep and meaningful loving connections need stability, need that everyday life aspect to them. It's not all fireworks and passion. It's also everyday life, groundedness. And perhaps that is the mountain to climb, knowing or learning that true love and or true connections are, and the lasting ones have a very grounded, very normal aspect to them as well, which makes them long lasting. So it seems for many of you, you've found a wonderful thing, something that you've been looking for, whether it's another, a significant other, or whether it's the right home or the right job. And just to take your time, don't burn it out. Take your time, learn with it, let it grow slowly, put your focus into it, and let it become something of stability for you. So there you have it, Aries. I hope you enjoyed your reading and that it resonates with you. And if so, please remember to hit the like, share, and subscribe buttons. And then have a good 2 weeks, and God bless you till we meet again.